What is up, Pats Nation? It is Patriots Global here with another video. So today we are really going to be talking about why this Patriots defense is having so many issues. If you watched my video on should Patriots fans worry about the Patriots, then you heard me reference this and you heard me talk about how I'm going to be making a video on the defense because that is what is really struggling and that is what is the most worrisome. This offense has Tom Brady, so it's obviously going to get better. They have two star wide receivers coming back by week five, so boom right there. But this Patriots defense is just not getting there. Now, week one, this defense was dominating versus the Texans, and that gave Patriots fans a lot of hope. And then you go to week two versus the Jags, and all of that fell through, and it looked like the team we saw in the Super Bowl. Now, looking back at how the Texans are doing, that win doesn't seem as great because the Texans are now 0-3 and are doing very, very, very terrible. So, to start off, we're going to be talking about the Patriots' defensive line. This defensive line cannot get to the quarterback at all. They were letting Matthew Stafford have a tea party back there. They were letting Blake Bortles have a tea party back there in week two. They just cannot get to the freaking quarterback. Now, since Trey Flowers has been out, the one guy that I will say has seamlessly been able to get to the quarterback is defensive end Dietrich Wise. He also is just always trying to hype up this defense. Great guy all around. But everyone else is just terrible. Adrian Claiborne is just not applying any pressure, which he was brought in to do. And to be quite honest, Claiborne all around has just been extremely silent and inconsistent. And the Patriots just have a group of mediocre defensive tackles. You have Danny Shelton, who was a former first round pick. He was a bust. You have Malcolm Brown, who's a former first round pick. He's a straight bust also. You then have Lawrence Guy, who really isn't that bad. And then you have Adam Butler, who just can't stop the run, but might be the Patriots' best pass rushing defensive tackle. Now, I'm going to be very, very broad with this statement, but the huge issue with this Patriots defense is just how slow they are. Now, it's not necessarily one specific position on the defense. Everyone on that defense is slow, but mainly the linebackers are the slowest. I have one question for you guys. Have you literally seen Hightower make a single play since the season has started? Let me rephrase that. Have you seen Hightower make a play at all this offseason? Or even the regular season at all since he has come back from football? Many, many, many people said a big reason that this defense was terrible last season was because Hightower was missing. Well, guess what? Hightower's back, and the Patriots are still doing terrible, and he is not doing anything, so what's the excuse now? It's pretty sad when the Patriots' probably fastest linebacker is Juwan Bentley. Now, he was said to be an extremely slow linebacker coming out of the draft, and that he really just couldn't cover. But last night, he was covering, I don't know if it was a wide receiver or what, but he went 20 yards down the field to cover this guy and made an interception. If I'm going to be honest, since this season has started, he has been the Patriots' best linebacker. Hightower was showing how slow he was, especially last night. Kyle Van Noy is fairly slow, but just very inconsistent. And then Eldon Roberts, he's just slow. He's just slow as frick. I don't think that it's necessarily that this defense isn't executing well. I think that the problem is that they are too slow to be able to make the plays. The Patriots' fastest linebacker was Marquise Flowers, who could also get to the quarterback. And for some reason, for some stupid reason, they let him go this offseason when they had to make their 53-man roster cutdowns, and then the Lions ended up grabbing him. He had 3+ sacks last season and was easily the Patriots' fastest linebacker. Why did we get rid of him? At a position that we needed athleticism, why did we get rid of him? I feel like Bill Belichick being the Patriots' general manager is just not working out well because he lets his ego, for better words, get in the way. We all know Bill Belichick is very stubborn. He might be the most stubborn guy that I've ever. Well, I can't say known because I don't know him personally, but yeah, we're still going to say known. He doesn't want to give up a lot for good players. And then to make things even worse, he doesn't want to give up the money to sign these good players. He didn't want to give Jabal Sheard money. Okay, bye. He signs with the Colts. He didn't want to give Danny Amendola the money. Okay, bye. Now he's with the Dolphins. You cannot constantly be bringing in average players and expecting them to become above average. And then to make things even more confusing, the Patriots entered the 2018 draft with 2 first round picks. We all knew that this defense was arguably the thing that needed the most remodeling this offseason. Bill Belichick uses those 2 first round picks on offensive players. Look, you could have used 1 on offense and 1 on defense, but you knew how much we needed a bolt of young and athletic defensive players, and you didn't do anything to get that. This Patriots defense does not look hype, it does not look motivated, it doesn't even look like they really care. And I'm not going to say it's everybody on the defense, because there's definitely some guys who are out there doing the best they can that are hype and are ready to terminate any offense that comes their way. But if not everybody on that defense wants the same thing, and if even one person gets lazy and stops caring, then the whole defense is going to suffer. And that's exactly what we have seen the past 2 weeks. This Patriots secondary has been horrendous. But I think a very decent part of this Patriots secondary being as bad as it is because they have to cover for an extended period of time because this defensive line cannot get to the quarterback. The quarterback can just sit there and wait for his offensive players to get open. And we cannot be greedy as fans and expect these secondary players to cover them for as long as they possibly are supposed to. Now, with that being said, I also do think that this Patriots secondary does need an upgrade. Especially with Patrick Chun being banged up, they need some help. I literally saw Cyrus Jones on the field last night playing corner. It was a 3rd down and he ended up missing the tackle, just like Cyrus Jones always did. So whether it's a safety or a corner, the Patriots need help, and there is still people on the open market that they can get. Go ahead and get Eric Reed if you really need him. You brought in cornerback Bashaud Breeland earlier this offseason, and it seemed like they were very interested, and then we literally stopped hearing about anything. He still has not been signed by a team. He could very, 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 very well be a good number 2 corner. It has become very, very, very obvious that signings need to happen, both offensive-wise and defensive-wise, but especially defensive-wise. But yeah, that's really all that I have to say for today's video. What are your guys' thoughts on this defense, and how do you think that it could be improved? Make sure you guys share this video with everybody who knows we can go to the Patriots Global Family, and other than that, I'll catch you guys in another video.